Thank you. host, Tebo, not Degero. We're currently waiting for a firestorm because he apparently is dead or something. Maybe he's in another side tournament, who knows? So I'm not actually going to be commentating, I'm just kind of just here. Garbo's going to be actually commentating. Oh, Garbo says he can't commentate. Okay, I guess I am commentating. Scouting people, asking them if they want to help commentate. It'd be pretty fun. Oh, Wumbo just PV'd. Activation. That'd be really awkward if I was. Ah, fuck. The Tebo in chat actually lies, I'm the real Tebo. Hello, Tebo. Or rather, Dal, I should say. Actually, where is Dal? You could ask him if he wants to commentate. It's 5 a.m. for Dal? Oh, okay, yeah. He does want to fix his sleep schedule, doesn't he? Apparently, Firestorm has responded. So we should be starting very soon. I just gotta open TOP. Which is taking forever for some reason. Do you click on the Tetris application or do you click on TOP Launcher? Thank you. So Wombo fought Firestorm earlier in the bracket, but then, because this is double elimination, if I'm correct, Firestorm went through the loser's bracket, and now they have to rematch. Alright, both players are now in the room. Should be exciting. Is this a first to 15? What is this? I forget. They are deciding to do two warm-ups now. Last time they played... Okay, yeah, first to 15. Last time Firestorm and Wombo played, there was a lot of 4-wide going on. Wombo, of course, well-known for his 4-wide. Firestorm, on the other hand, although Ingestris, you often see him just going for perfect clears or maybe even just doing regular T-spins in order to counter 4-wide, but Firestorm seems to have opted for going for side 4-wide as a response. I guess we'll see whether or not he decides to keep doing that or change things up this time. So, warm-ups. Wombo starts perfect clear. Probably just deciding, let's work on mid-game for a warm-up. No need to go all out. I'm not going to be fully commentating this, by the way, because it's just warm-up. What are your guys' thoughts on who's going to win? Firestorm or Wombo? Wombo did take it the first time they fought, but you don't necessarily know if he'll be able to do it again. That is one round of the warm-ups. Also, there's a huge delay between the stream and chat. It's unfortunate. Oh well. Nah. This is like, there's low latency mode, but it's also just possible, I don't know, Twitch is just like, nope, too bad. But in any case, that is the first two warm-ups done. It was 1-1, huh? They are planning to... Okay, they're gonna leave to reset the score. And game one starts. Firestorm goes for side 4-wide. Wombo starts with his signature center 4-wide. Firestorm does start his combo a little bit earlier, and Wombo looked like he misdropped, but that eyepiece, he will continue his combo, and it looks like he does have to accept a little bit of garbage, but it's nothing too dangerous for him. Firestorm now is just going back for normal mid-game, sets up some T-spins, while Wombo has not managed to go down very far, unfortunately. But as I say that, he actually gets a big down stack and almost reaches the bottom of his field, but Firestorm's APM is monstrous, and he's able to send Wumbo straight back up to the top. Now, Wumbo has gone a very clean field here. While Firestorm is super pressured, he's not going to be able to get down, and the first game goes to Wumbo. Game 2 starts. Firestorm starts with a TKI instead of 4-widing here. I don't know what just happened, but Firestorm won. Wait, what? Okay, whatever. Next game. Firestorm starts with side 4-wide again. Wumbo center 4-wide. What on earth happened that past round? It's just descended T-spin. Wumbo must have misdropped. This next game, Firestorm seems to be building his 4-wides much faster than Wumbo. And then if Wumbo messes up his combo just once, he can't take any damage whatsoever. Just instantly gets knocked out. So now they both start with their combo. Firestorm only slightly ahead of Wumbo this time. In fact, actually, Wumbo has a bigger combo, so he comes out on top. Both players then going through a little bit of garbage to keep their field cleaner for starting to send some larger sends of AP. Firestorm is getting a little bit pushed up here. While Wumbo's field is very clean, he has that sidewall, making it slightly more difficult to go for more T-spins. But he does find good donation opportunities so that his APM stays high. Now, Firestorm has a very high up, but he doesn't get his eyepiece or T-piece in time, and he gets KO'd. Score is now 2-2. It's much more even than last time. Well, Firestorm maybe with a slight misdrop there with that O piece at the top. So Wumbo's going to be able to send his 4-wide first, and Firestorm cuts his combo and gets knocked out. Next round, Wumbo is up 1. Wumbo, because he's building center 4-wide, he's always able to stack up a little bit higher. But Firestorm always manages to send his combo off earlier. It's hard to say which one is necessarily better, because Firestorm is a very fast player when it comes to these games. It's not to say that Wumbo's own skill is anything to laugh at. He's definitely able to keep up with Firestorm as shown in these matches. But here, there's a little bit of comboing going on in the middle of the game, because Wumbo's just in a tough spot from Firestorm's damage. Just lots of downstacking going on. Yeah, and Wumbo is able to get his field much cleaner than Firestorm's. Firestorm has constantly been around the middle to like top half sort of his field. And Wumbo seems to not have enough speed to really get through all that's being sent to him and gets topped out. Score is still tied 3-3. Firestorm stacking his side 4-wide much faster than Wumbo's center 4-wide. But here, Firestorm actually sends a small combo before stopping because he wasn't able to continue in order to keep up his combo. But he actually manages to get a 17 combo because of that with the garbage that was sent to him. Now, TOP, I believe, is change on attack. And so a lot of these end combos are sending very clean garbage to him. So he's able to use that garbage afterwards, even if his combo is shorter, for easy, like quick Tetrises for free APM. In the next game, Wumbo actually does send his 4-wide sooner than Firestorm's, but Firestorm is able to mostly cancel it out, ending up with a free Tetris into some good T-spins. He's not doing anything very fancy, just trying to keep it clean, but Wumbo's APM is just destroys in that round. Again, both players going for 4-wides, side versus center. So here, Wumbo looks like he's under a lot of damage. We'll see whether or not he's able to counter all of it. He is able to counter the majority of it with a 16 combo. So now both players very high up. We'll see. Firestorm seems to be in a better spot here, able to send a 6 combo with a Tetris in the middle, topping Wumbo out. score is now 5-4 with Firestorm in the lead. This is definitely a much closer game. Oh, but Firestorm, while building his, while doing the combo for his side 4-rod, misdrops that Z-piece. Doesn't look like he's going to be able to efficiently continue his combo, but no, he actually is. And he seems to be all right right now. He just needs to clear a little bit more, but one piece away from getting the eyepiece. He is, gets topped out. Next round, more 4-wide. Wombo's top of his stack is looking a little awkward. It seemed as if he wanted to put a T-piece there, but had to start his combo. So here it looks almost as if Firestorm had gotten the better of him for that combo, but then Wombo was able to find some good T-spin opportunities and send some damage. Now Firestorm, now that he's low on his field, he's basically going to start playing some Ultra. Looked as if he was going for a T-spin triple tower, but decides against it, thinking maybe my field cleaner can't be doing anything too greedy. Just starts downstacking. Both players finding good T-spins. There's a lot of skimming going on. That eye piece by Wombo might be a little bit of a problem, but he does have to deal with a lot of damage while he spent those few vital pieces trying to clean up. And Firestorm takes the next round. Five, six still. Very close game. Firestorm sending his 4-wide sooner before Wombo. That garbage is favorable for Wombo, so he should be able to continue his combo a little bit more. And a perfect cancel. Now Firestorm, actually, after going for the side 4-wide, goes for a center 4-wide. Wombo was not ready for that at all. Oh my goodness, Firestorm. You've seen this a few times from him before, where after he goes for one 4-wide, if he came out on top, finished his combo earlier, he sometimes transitions to another combo, but that was the first time he's done it this match. We'll see whether or not he can do it again. Wombo's combo was unfortunately not long enough, and he took almost a full screen's worth of damage, but then was not able to keep living. We'll see here, Wombo has to take 6 lines of garbage. His combo is longer though, so he is able to pressure Firestone quite a bit. Of course, players of these caliber, they are very, very strong in their survival. And Firestone manages to take all that garbage and send it right back to Wombo. So now both players just kind of looking for some T-spins, sending some damage, the usual mid-game. Wombo is much lower, seems to be going for slightly more Tetrises than Firestorm, because Firestorm needs to downstack a little bit more, sending small combo. Yeah, both players still keeping it cool. Lots of exchanges going on. Firestorm was unable to downstack enough, and he gets knocked out. So the score is now only 6-8. Still a comfortable lead for Firestorm, I would say, but Wombo definitely does still have a chance at winning this. Here we see Wombo's combo is significantly more stronger than Firestorm's. If Firestorm does not get those eyepieces in time, he's not going to be able to live, but he does manage to get to it. So now both players are around the middle of the field. Wombo might be in a little bit of trouble here with that Jameis drop, but he is almost completely out now. If he can, yes, he does get those eyepieces, and now he's back at the bottom of the board. Firestorm, on the other hand, misdropped that eyepiece on the side, so he's going to have to do a lot of skimming and trying to stay alive, but he doesn't manage to do it, so now it is 7-8. One more for Wombo, and then it's all tied up. Ooh, this time, Firestorm stacks almost to the very top of his board. So he should be able... Oh, he ends it with a perfect clear, too. Wow. That is crazy, Firestorm. Will he be able to get enough damage to finish off Wumbo, though? That's the question. It's looked like he's always been so close to being able to do it. Is he going to be able to? Almost. He's got to squeeze out that last little bit of damage. Firestorm, however, in his haste to try and knock out Wumbo, he misdrops a couple of pieces. So Wumbo takes that opportunity and is now... Now, both players seem to be doing all right. Wumbo, maybe a little bit higher up. Scarbridge is not the most favorable. He's got a late IP, so instead of going for Tetris's, he has to combo it out. But that's not enough damage to offset what Firestorm is pulling off, so Firestorm takes that round. Both players showing very remarkable skill, I must say. Now here, it looks like Wumbo's combo is, in fact, bigger, so he's going to send more damage than Firestorm. Oh, but that T-piece by Firestorm looks like he is going to have to dig through a little bit of garbage before he can get down. And as I say that, he immediately comes down. That's just what these players are. They are, these are, this is the finals after all. Wumbo goes for a well-made C-spin, providing a huge spike of damage to Firestorm. So now Firestorm is at the very top of his field. But with that clean well on the side, he's able to just combo it all out, and he is comfortably in the middle of his field now. Games where it's so fast, you can take quite a bit of damage before you're really, really in danger, because you can just keep down stacking and everything's all right. But if you have a big misdrop like that J there, that tends to stall your APM. And if your opponent is in a good position, then they will be able to counter it, take advantage of that. So yeah, Firestorm's field is looking a little messy here. This could be Wumbo's chance to try and knock out Firestorm, but unfortunately looks like Wumbo has to go for some Tetris stacking, which isn't as efficient in sending more T-spins. But Firestorm kept doing a couple of little misdrops here and there, which in such fast-paced games like this, just those few pieces matter so much. And then you could be in a lot of trouble, so you have to waste your eyepiece instead of using it for a Tetris. But Wumbo also had a couple of misdrops, so now he's pushed up to the top. It looks like Firestorm might be able to knock him out here. Wumbo does not have any combo to get out, and he gets KO'd. Firestorm is now 3 rounds ahead. Only 5 more and he wins. Can Wumbo keep his title in winners? Wait, this is double elimination, so also Wumbo out 4-whited. This is double elimination, so if Firestorm wins, he has to win another first to 15, right? That's how this thing goes? Pretty sure that is. Anyway, both players 4-widing. Wumbo then switching to a 3-6 stack. Firestorm's 4-wide was shorter. Now the score is 9-10 in those few moments where I went on a small tangent. Oh, but Wumbo misdrops his 4-wide at the top. It's going to be a very small combo of only 8. Firestorm just is going to be able to send a much, much higher combo. Okay, maybe only 12, but that could have been the chance. Oh, misdrop by Firestorm decides to build a couple of T-spins on top before starting to clean out his stack. Wumbo sends a quick T-spin double into Tetris, and now his score is tied up. Tebow, say something about the game. T.O.P. is very T.O.P. Very top? I don't know, whatever. Top is very top. So Wumbo combo actually gets cut short, or gets cut in the middle there. So he is just barely going to counter the damage that is sent at him. If he is able to open up as well, so despite Firestorm's attempts at trying to top him out, Wumbo is able to live just a little bit longer. This garbage is not looking the best, but games with such short line clear delay doesn't matter nearly as much. He keeps skimming and everything will sometimes work out pretty damn. So now Wumbo's back at the bottom of his field, sees some good T-spin singles, which are extremely efficient. there's a lot of these small like attacks into combos for like 3-4-ish combos going on, because you have just so quick line clear delay, you can afford to do that. And these players are insanely fast, just sending free damage in the form of clean garbage is not always your best idea. You don't necessarily want the most APM. After all, you win games by topping out your opponent and staying alive until then. But Wumpo actually misdrops that eyepiece at the very, very top of his field, so he's going to get knocked out there. In games of such high APM between players of these calibers, just one misdrop, even if it doesn't completely mess up your field, just the fact that you have to spend a couple more pieces to clean it up will hurt quite a bit. So, next game, Wumbo's field not looking the best right now, but he is able to clean it up mostly. Firestorm throws that Z-piece over his well. It's going to be very awkward for him to try and fix that, especially with that J on top. And just leads into more and more misdrops. The score is now 11-11, all tied up. If Wumbo wins four more, he is going to be able to take the round. And here, actually, Wumbo does not go for four wide. He tried going for it at the very beginning, but then his stack was a little messed up, so he just started doing some T-spins. And Firestorm, while he did have the side four wide fully built, his combo must have broken. He just wasn't able to counter it. Now, Wumbo's combo, unfortunately, has to break short there because he did not have the piece in order to fill up the side. So Firestorm takes a free win to four wide. Firestorm, his stack goes up all the way to the top. His combo might be a little bit longer, but his combo cuts short and Wumbo tops him out. It is now 13-12. Two rounds for Wumbo and three more for Firestorm. I have Messenger open. Oh, wait, I'm not streaming it. You guys can't hear that. Sweet. Any case, Firestorm gets a 14 combo, the exact same as Wumbo's, but Firestorm's field looks just a little bit better, but that eyepiece is going to cost him a little bit before he can reach that huge well of his. So he missed the chance to actually knock out Wumbo. Wumbo's able to stay alive here and try and clean up his field before Firestorm is able to do anything, because he too, his field is looking not the best. Both players are kind of near the middle of the field, just exchanging some damages back and forth. Wumbo is very, very high up, but he is always able to offset the majority of the damage that Firestorm sends at him. But Firestorm, with a clean field, just pulls off insane amounts of damage. Score is now 13-13. A 16 combo for Firestorm, instantly KOing Wumbo. That's the problem with 4 wide. If you just mess up once, then it's like, well, you get knocked. Of course, 4 wide is incredibly powerful. And in a tournament like the finals, you might as well use everything that you have. That is 15-13 now. I believe Firestorm, because he came from losers, they have to do the run back. Wow, very impressive from Firestorm. Definitely being able to pull off better games than he was last. Drink water, guys. Stay hydrated. Honestly, I don't even know what I'm supposed to be saying for mid-game. I just say like random stuff and just hope it works out. So I can't even see like any of setups because like, they just go so fast. And there's a lot of comboing going on. I personally don't play TOP, so I don't know much of the mechanics. But they are getting a lot of clean garbage, so I feel like it's change on attack. I can just Google this right now. TOP damage is weird. Where's the hard drop page for it? I found the forum page. We heard that both players agreed not to use the Daguerre opener because it is too OP and unethical. I don't know about OP, but unethical, maybe. That's a fun opener. I never actually did show it last time I was streaming, unfortunately. Oh well. I'll try and pull it off sometime. So Firestorm is he back? Yeah, Firestorm is back. He's ready. Both players have left the room, reset the count. And now this is the second time, or third time actually, they will be playing together. First time, Wumbo was able to beat Firestorm. I think he was PBing pretty badly, I think. This time, Firestorm beat him, I don't even remember the score, it was like 12, 11, 15 or something. Anyway, both players going for 4-wide. Their 4-wide combo was roughly even, no player getting too much garbage here, so now they're both towards the middle of the field. Firestorm is a little bit higher up, and it looks like his field might be a little bit messier than Wumbo's, so Wumbo goes for some small down stacks into a T-spin triple, pushing Firestorm way up. Is Firestorm going to be able to live? No, he does not. He actually, I think, misdropped the T-piece, but wasn't able to get it over for the T-spin, and he gets knocked out. Next round, more 4-wide. Firestorm's 4-wide is a little bit faster, of course, as always, and he ends it with a perfect clear. That is absolutely crazy. So how does this man do it? It looked like Firestorm was going for another 4-wide of some sort, or at least some sort of combo, but then while trying to get the Z-piece in, he misdrops it, covering his hole, and Wumbo is able to take advantage of that and knock. So that's two rounds in a row for Wumbo at the very start. Good start. Now, next game, Firestorm starts off with a 16 combo. Wumbo is not able to offset the damage, and he gets knocked out. So, next game, that is the first round for Firestorm in this set. Looks like Wumbo's combo is going to be bigger than Firestorm's, even though it cut off a little bit. So, actually, that cutting off his combo earlier resulted in Firestorm getting a larger combo, and now Firestorm decides to transition into a center 4-wide, but it's only an 8 combo. So while it's decent damage, not as much as you would want it to be when you're going for a build such as 4-wide. Both players then just eating through all their garbage before sending off some T-Sins and Tetrises. It's definitely a lot of Tetrises or combos into Tetrises I'm seeing versus a back-to-back heavy game like PPT, for example. I actually haven't seen them play like Tetris in a while. So maybe they have similar play styles. I think Firestorm's play style in
Chestris is a much more T-spin heavy sort of thing, because he just has the speed to constantly play Ultra. So now this game, both players were able to offset each other's damage perfectly. So their fields are very even. Wumbo is able to use his garbage and before Firestorm is able to. So now Wumbo is pulling off some big spikes that Firestorm is just unable to counter. So Firestorm is now, or Wumbo is now comfortably in the lead by 3 rounds. Okay, that's not comfortably, I guess, but he's in the lead. His combo seems to cut short a tiny bit, perhaps. Well, both players just finding T-spin opportunities, then always trying to make sure that they are able to reach their garbage so they don't get overwhelmed too much. It's just a constant APM, just going everywhere. Just constant back and forth going on. One player goes up to the nearly tippy top. The other one spends all their effort trying to knock them out, but then they always manage to bring it back. And because TOP garbage is so clean, and they're able to send it right. So Wumbo there was actually able to top out Firestorm there. So now he's 4 rounds ahead of Firestorm, pulling off a much better performance. And as I say that, actually, Wumbo messes up his 4-wide, is able to recover mostly, so it's not the end of the world for him. Now Firestorm is pretty high up, and Wumbo just sending off constant combos. Firestorm can't do anything about it, and he gets knocked out. 6-1. Again, both players going for some 4-1. Firestorm actually is able to get ahead in this combo. Now, it looks like Wumbo is actually taking a book out of Firestorm, or taking Leaf out of Firestorm's books. It built up for a side 4-wide, but unfortunately did not have the pieces to start comboing it. And now he has to spend a little bit of time just skimming through everything, trying to get to the bottom and touching his garbage. Otherwise, he just gets overwhelmed like that. Firestorm takes a second round of this set. Again, both players 4-widing. Wumbo actually sending off his 4-wide. First, he has a 16 combo. Firestorm takes 2 lines of garbage. But Wumbo, again, just going from 4-wide into 4-wide. Is he? Oh, and Firestorm messes up terribly, dropping 2 S-pieces in the middle of his stack. Wumbo will surely be able to take advantage of that, right? Unfortunately, Firestorm is just a monster at this downstacking business. Even has some small misdrops, but is able to still stay alive here. Wumbo also having a couple misdrops of his own. We'll see whether or not it affects him. It looks like it won't. Just comboing out, offsetting all the damage that the other player is sending. Now, Firestorm, once he got down, just started sending a lot of T-spins and Tetrises, and was able to top out Wumbo. Next game, can Firestorm keep his win streak up? No, he cannot. Wumbo now 7-2, Firestorm's 3. So Wumbo's combo looks as if it'll be a little bit longer than Firestorm. Oh god, am I lagging? Or are they lagging? I'm probably lagging. Okay. Well, yeah, Wumbo's combo is longer than Firestorm's. So Wumbo then has to start using his own pieces to build up some damage while Firestorm is able to quickly access his garbage. So Wumbo near the bottom of his field here. Of course, Firestorm, while he's at the very tippy top right now, looks like he should be able to just barely survive with a 7 combo. Now, Wumbo decides to chew through his garbage before sending any damage so that he won't be suddenly overwhelmed by any shenanigans Firestorm wants to pull off. And it works out for him, so now Firestorm takes his 8th round of the match. Firestorm builds up his side 4-wide faster than Wumble's. Wumble, you'll see, has those two little gaps there in his 4-wide. That might be enough to make him eat a lot of damage. It actually is not. Wumble manages to completely counter that. And then Firestorm follows up that first 4-wide with another 4-wide, but the combo wasn't nearly as big as he would have liked. So he just transitions back towards standard mid-game, building some T-spins and stuff. A lot of just pushing one player up to the very top before one player starts to misdrop. Now, Wumbo here sees opportunity for a side 4-wide, goes for it, and takes the round easy peasy for him. It's now 9-3. Wumbo is pulling off a much more convincing game this time than he is perhaps either of the past two games that they've played together in TOP in this tournament. Yeah, this is a lot of back and forth going on between the two players. Wumbo, unfortunately, his combo cut short there, and Firestorm just takes that round easy peasy. So here, Firestorm's combo is actually much bigger than Wumbo's. Wumbo just is not able to counter it fully and gets instantly topped out. Could this be the Firestorm comeback? Wumbo's 4-wides are definitely looking a little bit messier than they have in the previous rounds. It's not to say that Wumbo is, his combo cut short again. It's now 6-9. Nice. In any case, Firestorm drops the S piece on top of his combo well, so his combo is going to be cut short just a tiny bit. One true combos, which in a game where it's 4-wide versus 4-wide, it could make the potential difference. Unfortunately, in this game, unfortunately for Wumbo, it's not the case in this round, but you never know. Firestorm going for a small little well on the side, trying to just downstack a little bit before he can reach that garbage so that he doesn't get topped out. Wumbo here staying very, very low on the board, where in a game where it's so back and forth, you want to make sure that you don't stay too high, otherwise your opponent might suddenly throw a spike at you and then you just get topped out. Yeah, so that TP's Firestorm threw on the side there might come back to bite him in the butt later. Now Wumbo understands that there's a little chance, or there's a little gap in the damage being thrown at him, so he goes for a 4-wide into some touch. Firestorm, however, is able to live because the 4-wide was not long enough, but that L might spell the end of him. Firestorm is able to clear up just about all of it entirely now, so both players are doing quite all right, and there are a few. So now both players kind of just throwing damage back and forth, going for small combos here. Firestorm might get topped out here. Looked like he was trying to go for a side 4-wide, but does he have the pieces to send it? He gets a 7 combo, so it looks all right for him, but that J piece hurts quite. This gives a chance for Wumbo to send a lot of damage at him. Looks like that those eyepieces are coming pretty late. Is Wumbo going to be able to take advantage of this situation? He does manage to live, luckily for him, but Firestorm is now at the very bottom of his board, and Wumbo was pretty pressured, but he takes care of it now with, unfortunately, two misdrops actually with the S and T piece. So Firestorm, while was at the very bottom of his board, he's just going to keep sending some T-spins and Tetrises, topping Wumbo out. That is a 4-game win streak now for Firestorm. Only 3 games separate these two players right now. And this is the winner's finals? Yeah, this is winner. That's the right word for it. So if whoever wins this set wins the entire tournament. I guess both players started with a 4-wide. Firestorm, unfortunately, has a couple of misdrops, and whenever one person misdrops, it's up to the other person. Can they take advantage of that and send enough APM to just destroy them? Both players are high APM players. Does TOB have an APM thing? Anyways, Firestorm, his combo is a little bit longer, and he transitions from a side 4-wide into a small sort of 3-wide thing going on. And it did not work amazingly for him, but it's definitely enough to keep Wumble pressure. Both players constantly needing to skim just to stay alive in these situations. It looked like Firestorm actually tried going for a little bit of a center four wide and managing to get a 4 or 10 combo with a T-spin double in the middle. So Wumble almost got knocked out, but it wasn't enough damage for Firestorm. So Wumble's still alive and is barely pulling through, hanging on for his dear life, and he gets topped out. That was, now it's 10-8. Yes, oh, grand finals bracket reset. That's the proper term for it. Both players four widening as always. Wumbles, unfortunately, he recognized that his combo got cut and built a little bit more so that his combo will be slightly longer. Ends up with an 11 combo, and his field is extremely clean. Not to say that Firestorms isn't. Both players just always mindful of their garbage, constantly needing to be able to reach it. Now, Wumbo sees an amazing combo there for him to get down and send a ton of damage back at Firestorm. Firestorm is extremely pressured. Is he going to be able to live? He is just barely going to be able to live for now, but that S piece made him pause for just a little bit longer. So we'll see if this combo by Wumbo, a 6 combo, will do much. Firestorm is actually able to offset just about all of it before transitioning into another center 4-wide going on. This is the most 4-wide I have seen in a, like, forever, including mid-game 4-wides. Both players just taking every single opportunity they can to just try and launch one in order to finish the other player off. Here, Firestorm very high up, but is able to get that Tetris. So now Wumbo might be in a tiny bit of trouble here, sending off a couple of Tetrises in response. So now both players are fairly comfortably just sending damage back and forth. Wumbo a little bit high up, but he should, might not be able to live here. Firestorm is very low on his field. Wumbo has to do a lot of skimming in order to live. The eye is going to hurt him quite a bit too. Is Firestorm going to be able to take it? Wumbo just keeps finding these good down stacks. Is Firestorm not able to finish him off? So Wumbo is now in the clear, actually reaches the bottom of his board, builds up for a T-spin into a small combo, which seems to be very, very common between these two players. They're just sending those little combos to add that extra little bit of damage. And then with line clear delay so short, you can always afford to do it. Now Firestorm at the bottom of his field, small slight misdrops, but he does have the room to work with it. So Wumbo takes the opportunity to stay a little, to just clean up his field and get all the way down. So those small combos adding up together are able to knock out Firestorm. And that was a very long round. Score is now 11-8. And both players four widening. Wumbo's combo looks much, much bigger than Firestorm's, instantly knocking out Firestorm. 12-8 now. It's very tragic to see either player mess up their 4-wide, just instantly getting knocked out. Now Firestorm here, he found the 4-wide and then transitions into another 4-wide. So Wumbo recognizes that Firestorm's also 4-widing after his first one, so he builds up his own 4-wide. Eats up a lot of garbage, but he does have immediate access to his garbage hole and is able to send off some more combos into Tetris. So even though he was very high up, he wasn't in any danger whatsoever. Now Firestorm here, a little bit higher up, he's going to take a little bit to reach a garbage, but he is going to reach it anyway. Now, both players are at the very bottom of their field, just offsetting all the damage that the other is able to send. And then Firestorm finding a good T-spin double into another T-spin double into a Tetris, which sends Wumbo up to the very top of his board. We'll see whether or not Firestorm is able to dish out that APM or dish out the damage to knock him out, but Wumbo immediately just counters back, reaching the bottom of his board, sending Firestorm straight. Just so much back and forth action going on. Both players constantly needing to reach the garbage, otherwise they'll just get knocked out immediately because the other player is such a strong player. Wumbo here just sending off some good Tetrises before touching his garbage to send off more Tetrises. Finds a good T-spin opportunity into a small downstep. Wumbo here with a good double dagger. But Wumbo is able to offset all the damage with the combos of his. Now Wumbo a little bit high up. That L might hurt him a little bit. So Firestorm is at the very bottom of his field. Is he going for 4Y? No, he is not. Sends off some T-spins. Two more T-spins. Wumbo is constantly at the top of his board. It looks like he's not able to downstack or get down at all. So Firestorm is able to take the next round. Now again, both players 4Y-ing. Nothing much to say there. Wumbo wasn't able to start off his combo, so he had to eat up a little bit of garbage. We'll see whether or not it matters for him. It does matter. Firestorm is able to take the round with that 4Y. 10 to 12, much closer now. Firestorm is still in this. Now Firestorm's 4Y at the very top. He misdrops, and his combo will be cut short, but Wumbo is he messes up his 4Y and or his comboing just gets knocked out. So it didn't even matter that Firestorm missed drop there. Score is now 11 and 12. Definitely a very close game here. Both players 4Y-ing. Wumbo is able to counter just about all of it. Still needing to skim a little bit before he's able to reach that garbage well. Finds T-spin, but Firestorm on the other side is building into another 4Y. Finds a good 10 combo, pressuring Wumbo quite a bit here. See whether or not Wumbo is able to live. Sends off a lot of skims, and he is staying alive. Firestorm finds another side 4Y into a 10 combo with some doubles sneaked in there, and at will finish off Wumbo. Score is now tied 12 to 12. Both players again 4Y-ing. It looks like this Wumbo's 4Y is better, so he takes the lead 13 to 12. Extremely close games here. Firestorm misdrops that L near the bottom of the stack, but Wumbo also misdrops that O, so it won't be the end of Firestorm, but that I and Z placement certainly might be here. We're just skimming a little bit before he can access the well on the side. Likewise with Firestorm. Firestorm finds a lot of good T-spin opportunities here. Will Wumbo be able to counter it all? Almost counters. He's able to counter enough to stay alive for a little bit longer. Firestorm building a little bit of a combo. And Wumbo is now at the bottom of his board. Building a 3Y. That is rare. I have actually never seen Wumbo build a 3Y before. And it does not work out very well for him. He gets pressured very, very hard. But Firestorm here sends good T-spins into some Tetrises. Wumbo is at the very top of his board. Then during the time that Firestorm needs to build up to send off more damage, Wumbo is almost always able to get down, but not this time. Score is now 13-13. Both players just doing a first to two now to see who will win. Firestorm misdrops that Z-piece near the beginning of his 4Y, so he's going to send a small 4 combo, sending one line of damage before getting topped out by Wumbo. One more match for Wumbo, and he is able to win this round. Fourteen to 13. See, Firestorm not taking any chances, sending a side four wide into another side four wide. And Wumbo, his four wide is stronger, and he is able to top out Firestorm. Final score of 15-13. The winner of Tebow's TOP tournament is Wumbo Ties. What a game. Second round of sets was second set was definitely much closer than that first one. And there we have it. What do I do now? Tebow, say something. Yes, congratulations to Wumbo for winning. Very close games. This is very, very back and forth, too, with the nature of TOP. Okay, but actually, what do I do now? All right, we're ending stream now. Are you going to raid someone? Is anyone streaming? You should find someone to raid. This tournament finally over. Big thank you to Tebow for running it. It's always nice to see a new tournament that isn't just Gestures or PPT. Who to raid? I don't know. Do you want to raid this guy's playing Gestures. Is Evie on? Is Evie streaming? She is on. She's playing PPT. Oh, she's doing hamburger stacking. Nice. Okay, yeah, so Evie is another option. Golden streaming. Someone wants a rematch with Dormy. Yeah, just pick someone to raid. See you guys. Thank you to all the players for playing in Tebow's tournament. Thank you for Tebow for hosting the tournament. I'll be seeing you guys.